Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I know you've all been waiting for a guide for patch 10.15, the most balanced patch of set 3. Yes, the Avatar, aka Mortdog, has returned and brought peace amongst the four nations. Now, today we're going to be taking a look at one of the most consistent builds right now. What's that? You guessed it, we're gonna be talking about Mech and Friends. But don't worry, I'm gonna be taking you and guiding you step by step through the early, mid, and late game, even give you alternative variations. We're covering it all, that's right. Now, quickly, before we start, just take a second to subscribe, like, and hit that bell notification just so you know exactly when my next video goes live. I'm helping you, you're helping me, everybody's happy, but enough chit chat. Let's take a look at the guide. Now, I quickly want to touch on leveling because I want you to understand how the build works. None of these are rules. You're still going to level as you would normally. If you're win streaking, look to push the advantage, push the levels, keep that win streak going. If you have a weak board and you're loose streaking, look to prioritize economy. But the key thing with this build is that we're looking to stabilize with the mech, meaning we need a fizz. So increasing our odds of hitting that 4 cost unit is important. So something that you want to try to look for is going to level 5 on this stage right here to 6, okay? And if you can, right, I would only recommend this if you're win streaking, that's why I put this in orange, is to pre-level. Now I want to be clear about what pre-leveling means. Pre-leveling is when you're level 4 and your experience bar hits 8 out of 10. That means that on your next round, you're going to automatically level to 5, getting those increased odds of hitting that fizz, right? Hitting the 4 cost unit. And then again, because we're really trying to push for that fizz, we do want to try and level to 6 on 3-2. So our natural rolls throughout all of stage 3 are increased for the 4 costs. And then level 7, ideally by 4-1. And this is the stage where we really need to have our mech online. With leveling out of the way, I quickly want to touch on items now. Because mech is our stabilizing factor, this is the items that we are prioritizing for. We're going to have a secondary carry, and that being the Victor, which we'll talk on his items later on. But we are prioritizing mech items. Now, all of these 9 items are great for the mech, but one is most important because it's by far the best item for the mech, and that is the Titan Resolve. So this is the item that I always go for on my mech, and then after that it kind of depends on the lobby. Do you need dodge? Go for QSS, Shroud, Trap Claw. Do you want to look to get multiple ults off, or you need some lowering their resistances? Look to go for GA, Ionic Spark, right? It depends on the lobby. Now, Bloodthirster is a very specific item, and you only go for Bloodthirster if you're going for a specific variation, which we're going to touch on later in the video. With all of that said, the items that we're looking to prioritize on that very first carousel are Chain Vest and Glove. Here is the build that stabilizes us. What you'll notice is that we're not relying on hitting any 5 cost units, and that it's a level 7 board. This is the secret behind this being so consistent. We can roll at level 7 to hit a fizz, to hit a Victor, and stabilize off of that. Now, you'll notice that I have items on 3 carries, Rumble, Victor, and Shaco. But we will always be prioritizing the mech items and the Victor items. In some situations, you might have an early game where you have that early components for Guardian Angel and Bloodthirster. And if you have a good infiltrator, for example, you come across an early Shaco or Zed, then you can use them to stabilize by making these two items and have Shaco carry us through the mid game into the late game, going through that level 8. But the stronger carries are in fact mech and Victor, something to keep in mind. We have blue buff so that Victor can get his cast off. Now, why blue buff instead of Shojin? There was a recent guide on Reddit that goes through exactly every champion and what's better on them. Blue buff or Shojin. Shojin is better on Victor after his 4th ultimate, but if we're being realistic, there's not going to be many fights where Victor is getting 4 ultimates or more. So that's why my personal preference and strong belief is that blue buff is better on Victor, so you can get the 2-3 ultimates off in a fight. And then Morello is there for the anti-heal, right? Sometimes you need the anti-heal. If you're not looking, if the lobby doesn't require anti-heal, they don't have, you know, Celestial or Bloodthirster, stuff like that, then you can just look to go for the Rabadon's death cap instead. Now, quickly, I just want to touch on why do we always itemize the Rumble. For those of you who don't know, when basically the Garen breaks, when it falls apart, the strongest unit out of it, because they have low health, right, it's going to be the Rumble with the demo proc, right? So when we're going to level 8, we're looking to either add in the Ziggs or the GP for that demo, making the Rumble the strongest unit out of the mech. That's why we itemize it. Now, quickly, I want to touch on positioning, and this is something I learned from watching Kiyun, the mech expert. Why do we put our units like this, right? Why do I have Rumble here, Annie here, Fizz here? Why not just put them like this? Well, there's a trick behind it. So as you get better with scouting, right, scouting and knowing where to place the mech, we don't always want our mech spawning in the middle. Sometimes there's going to be opponents that all of their units are to the left. Sometimes they're always to the right. By positioning these three units up here, there's a very small adjustment you have to make to swap the mech over, right? Because if your mech is like this and you want to put it all to one side, you got to move three units, right? Or if they're like this and you need to go to the right, look, you need to do three movements to get them all over. But by having your units like this, you make one movement instead. Boom, and the mech is spawning here. Or boom, and the mech is spawning here. So keep your units like this. Scout, if you're tracking opponents, right, where you can tell who your next three opponents are, then you'll know, okay, two of the three are left side, so last second you put the Fizz here, or last second you move the Annie here. This is why we use this formation for the mech. Now, I want you to understand your power spike so you know exactly when you can go to level 8 right away instead and roll at level 8, or if you haven't hit your power spike and you need to roll at 7. So your biggest power spike is hitting the mech. So if you have the Fizz and you have two mech items out of all of them that we've talked about, so two mech items plus the Fizz, right, completing your mech, assuming you have the Annie and Rumble, you're stable. You can usually push to level 8 with this board. Your second condition is having a Shaco upgraded with Darkstar synergy, right, Karma, sometimes the Mordekaiser, and one of these two items. Now, Victor alone won't cut it unless you have the mech to go with it, because the way you really get value out of Victor is once he's getting multiple ultimates off, unless you have crazy items like Rabadon's blue buff and like Jeweled Gauntlet, something like that, where he's one-shotting the whole team in his very first ultimate, right? Now, let's take a look at the best early game that you can have going into this build. If you ever see this early game, the immediate thought going through your head should be, I can play mech from here. But I want to make a quick note on Soraka. Even after the nerfs, this unit is insane. That even if I have a Cassiopeia 2, as soon as I come across through a Soraka, I instantly swap it over. Now, your best three unit opener are the Rebels, Malphite, Ziggs, and Zed. Reason being is that each of them can hold our items for our carries. Malphite holds onto the mech items, Ziggs holds onto Victor items, and Zed holds onto Shaco items. Our level 4 board will either be a Brawler or an Infiltrator, and at level 5, we're adding in the one that we didn't get. And for early game positioning, if there's no Blitzcrank, you can put the Ziggs in the corner. If there is a Blitzcrank, then you quickly make this swap. So you have the Brawlers. I like putting Malphite out here as he's a little bit tankier. You put the Brawlers on each side. Zed can jump wherever. Nocturne can go wherever. That's the early game positioning. And at level 5, you're looking to add in that Rumble. So very strong, right? You're starting to get the mech units from this point on, right? You're going into level 6. Beautiful synergies. You have the item holders. And this board, especially if upgraded with some of the items that we need, can take you to level 7, to level 8, and slowly make those transitions over, right? If you hit the Shaco, go ahead and swap that over. The Annie can go in at level 7. The Fizz can go in over the Zed. You have the mech online. The Malphite Illaoi can start dropping out for the Victor, Karma, right? Until you eventually get to this board. All right, now let's take a look at the late game, because going to level 8 and adding in the GP is not enough to secure you first place. This can usually get you a top 4, but I want to show you how to really go for that first place positioning for maximum LP gains. So the late game transitions that you're looking to go into is 1. Make sure you're pushing for level 9 after this. And the swaps are basically the 5 cost units. Sorry, that's not the one. The one over here. So Karma comes out for Lulu 2. You only make these swaps when these 5 costs are 2 starred. Echo 2 goes in once you have that over, you place it over the Shaco. At level 9, you're looking to add in the Janna. Aurelion Soul is also a good option. So this is your, I would say, like, late game win condition, right? Pushing level 9, adding in the Janna, it's giving attack speed to Victor, to the mech, insane damage. You have your GP, Lulu 2, Echo 2. This is your strongest level 9 board with this particular variation. Now I do want to show you the 4 infiltrator variation that you got a glimpse of there, and this is the one where you're going to be looking to play the Bloodthirster on the Rumble. Why? Because you're getting much more attack speed, right, from 40% to 80% with 4 infiltrators. You're getting bigger value from that Bloodthirster. So you're looking to go Titan's Resolve, Bloodthirster, and Guardian Angel. This is the best combination you can go for this specific variation, right? So this is usually if you come across an early Echo and you haven't found a Victor, let's say. So you easily can go into that 4 infiltrator at level 8. And then it's usually the Aurelion Soul. Now, it doesn't have to be Aurelion Soul. It's just an easy unit because it's strong and it gives you Rebel Synergy for the Zed, right? Because you will be using the Ziggs. But an alternative is, you know, using GP instead here. And then Aurelion Soul can be like Victor or any good 5-cost unit, Janna, something like that. But this is the 4 Infiltrator variation with a Bloodthirster. That brings us to the end of the video. As always, thank you so much for watching up to this point. I hope you learned something new. Let me know in the comments below how the build worked out for you, if there's any new item variations you came up with, or a new just completely variation that I didn't discuss in this video. Let me know what you came up with. I'll see you in the next one.